Hi, in this video we're going to talk about combining probabilities, either with or events or and events. And we'll see what that looks like. We've got an example here. If you need the worksheet, you can get it on my website. So here's an example. You have 10 prizes in a bag, and people are going to draw them at random. These are academic prizes. Two are yellow erasers, one is a yellow calculator, three are green calculators, and four are red erasers. First, let's find the individual probabilities of each one. Okay, so I'm using the first letter. YE means yellow eraser. So we have two yellow erasers out of 10. This is good practice for our individual probabilities. If you want to try this out, you can pause the video and then start it back up again. Yellow calculator, we have one out of 10. I could also reduce this to 1/5. Green calculators are 3 out of 10. Red erasers are 4 out of 10, or 2/5. Okay, so that's one way to do the probabilities. We could also just look at the type of item. What's the chance of getting a calculator? How many calculators do we have? We've got one. And three more. So we've got 4 out of 10, or 2/5. What's the chance of getting an eraser? Two yellow erasers and four red. So 6 out of 10, or 3/5. These are complements of each other, right? There's only two possibilities, calculator or eraser. So these should add up to one. So 4 and 6 is 10, 2 and 3 is 5. So they do. Similarly, there's three different colors of items, so they should add up to one. So let's check that. So red items, the only red are the red calculators. So that's 4 out of 10, or 2/5. The yellow erasers, two of those, and a yellow calculator. So that's 3 out of 10. And then green, there are three green calculators, so 3 out of 10. Okay, does that add up to 10 out of 10? 6, 7, 8. No, it does not. What did I forget? Red. Oh, sorry, I was looking at the wrong one. I need to add up the tenths. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, it works. All right, now that we have some individual probabilities, let's look at how to combine those. So first we'll do the or events. There's two different possibilities. Either the events could be disjoint or overlapping. Okay, you know about these words from doing Venn diagrams. I'll just draw a quick little diagram. Disjoint, you know, are two separate events. They can't overlap each other. Overlapping means they do overlap. They have an intersection in the middle. So when you do OR events, you always add the probabilities. But we have to be careful if they're overlapping, not to add that middle part twice, not to count the intersection twice. Okay, so let's try this out. Let's go to the OR, which is examples A and B. What's the probability of drawing a yellow or green item? So yellow or green, these are disjoint. An item can be yellow or green, but it can't be both. There's no overlap in this situation. So disjoint, so that means we can add the probability of yellow. So yellow or green is equal to the probability of yellow plus the probability of green. We have our colors over here, and these are disjoint. So these all added up to one. And then the types added up to one. Okay, so the probability of yellow is 3/10, plus the probability of green is 3/10. So yellow or green altogether is 6/10. or 3/5. So when you say or, you're increasing your possibility. So that's why the probability gets larger. Yellow or green. Okay, let's double check this because we have our combined events up here. We have yellow eraser. So we would count yellow erasers plus yellow calculators plus green calculators. So that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 out of 10, or 3/5. So it worked. Okay, now what's the probability of drawing a red item or an eraser? Okay, red item or eraser, do these have anything in common? Do they have any overlap? There are some red items that are erasers, but there are also some erasers that are not red. So this is an over, these are overlapping sets. Okay, so we need to be careful that we don't double count probability red or eraser. So now I want to go up to these individual colors and the items to make sure we don't double count. So red or eraser. So we would count these yellow erasers, 2/10. Yellow calculator, we wouldn't count. Green calculator, we wouldn't count, but red eraser, we would count. So that is 4/10. So 6/10 or 3/5. We have to be careful. If we went down here and we did red or eraser, see how we would get 4/10 plus 6/10? That would be 100%. But we know that's not right because within red, well, red are all erasers, but in yellow, some are erasers, but some are calculators. So it's really important if you have overlapping sets to make sure that you're just counting them individually and not double counting anything in the overlap. Okay, so those are the or. Again, we still added. And because when you add things to when you do or, that increases your possibilities. Now, and that narrows down your possibilities. So we have two different situations for and. The first one is independent. Independent events. The second one is dependent. I think I'm going to get the events in there. Okay, so when we talked about or, we're talking about a single event, a single draw, drawing once out of the bag. With an and, we're talking about multiple draws. We want to know what's the chance of getting this and this and this. So we need multiple draws. Okay, so this one is called for independent. That's when we draw with replacement. Independent means the probability is the same every time. So if we draw a prize out, put it back in, then we start with the same, essentially same bag again, same probabilities. And so each time someone draws, we're drawing independently. It's probably not how a prize bag would work, but some other situations you might have drawing with replacement. Now, dependent events is drawing without replacement. This is more like a prize situation where someone would draw a prize and they would get to keep it, hopefully. Otherwise, it's not much of a prize. So it depends on the scenario here, whether it's with replacement or without replacement. Without replacement, that means it's called dependent because the bag now is different depending on what was drawn out in the first draw or the previous draws. So that's why it's called dependent events. In both cases, we're going to multiply. When they're independent, we can just multiply the individual probabilities. But for dependent events, we have to change the probability for each draw. So let me show you how to do that. This up a little bit. Okay, so for C, here's the first and event. If we put the items back in each time, that's with replacement. So that means they are independent events. Let's think of it as starting over the exact same way every single time. It's independent. Each draw is independent of the previous one. What's the probability of drawing three red erasers in a row? Okay, so we want probability of three red erasers. Think of this as getting probability red, we'll just use R, and red, and red. That means the first time you got a red, the second time you got a red, and the third time you got a red, and they're all erasers. We can multiply these individually. The chance that you get a red the first time, times the chance that you get a red the second time, times the chance that you get a red the third time. Well, those are going to be the same every time. So red eraser is 4 out of 10. Okay, I'm going to pause it and get my calculator. Okay, got my calculator here. So with fractions, you can multiply straight across, or you can use some kind of fraction. If your calculator does fractions, you can do it that way. So I'll do it a couple different ways. I'm going to do 4 fraction 10. So if your calculator does that, that's great. Oops, except I have to get out of the fraction. 4 fraction 10 and the right arrow times 4 fraction 10, right arrow, times 4 fraction 10. This calculator will do fractions for us, which is lovely, which is 8 out of 125. Okay, let's say you don't have a calculator that does that. You can do 4 times 4 times 4. I'll write it over here, 64. Out of 10 times 10 times 10, 1,000. Now it's a little harder to reduce. You can also cross cancel. You could do 2/5 times 2/5 times 2/5. That's a little easier to see that that's 8 out of 125. You could also go 64 out of 1,000, reduce it for you. Okay, so 8 out of 125. That's pretty slim, right? It's not very probable that you would get three red erasers in a row. So when you use and, you're narrowing down the possibility, so there's smaller chance of getting red and a red and a red. Okay, so that's putting the eraser back in each time. Well, what if we don't put, oops, it was marbles, but I changed them. What if we don't put the items back in each time? So that's drawing without replacement. So someone's actually drawing a prize and they get to keep it. What's the probability of drawing three red erasers in a row? So same idea, probability of three red erasers. But now it's not the same every time. These are dependent events. It depends on what was drawn before. So our probability is going to change each time. The first time, it's 4 out of 10. Because we have 4 erasers and 10 items. Now one eraser is gone. So how many red erasers are left? Only 3. And how many items are left? Only 9. So it's 3 out of 9 now. Now 2 red erasers are gone out of the bag. So there's only 2 left out of 8 items. Okay, let's punch this one in. Or reduce it however you like to do it. You can reduce it and then multiply. I don't know if that's going to multiply. 4/10 times 3/9 times 2/8 is 1 out of 30. Okay, interesting. Another way you can do it is if you like to cross cancel. I like to cross cancel and cross out. The four goes in once and twice. Three goes in once and three times. Two goes in once and five times. So you can see one times one times one. And 5 times 3 is 15, times 2 is 30. So that's another way you can do your fractions there. So 1 out of 30 versus 8 out of 125. Which one's bigger? Which one's more likely or less likely to get 3 erasers in a row if you put them back each time? Or 3 erasers in a row taking them out? This one's a little more likely, right? Because you're putting it back in, so you have a bigger chance. These second and third numbers are bigger than these two. So if we looked at the decimals, this one should be a little bigger than that one. So 8 out of 125 is 0.064. Oh, we could see it from there, 64 thousandths. And 1 out of 30 is 0.333. Keeps going. So almost twice as much, almost twice as likely to get it if you're putting them back each time than if you take them out. Kind of makes sense. Okay, so that's an overview of combining probabilities. First, we found some individual probabilities, and then we saw four different ways of four different types of problems that you're going to see. The disjoint, you add. If they're overlapping, you still add, but be careful not to overlap the middle or double count anything in the middle. For the and, you're multiplying. And if they're independent, the number's going to stay the same every time. If they're dependent, then it's going to change each time depending on what you're taking out. All right. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.